My freshman year was marked full of advices. And there was one senior student who told me, you know what? Don't take life so seriously. Nobody gets out alive anyway. Mr. Contest Chairman, fellow Toastmasters, and guests, how did I survive college with my sanity intact? Well, I'm going to tell you my story. I can still remember that first day in college. And I was staring at the golden gates of my future alma mater. And I was so excited, I told myself, I'm going to explore the world of possibilities. I'm going to dig the deep mystery of knowledge and indulge myself with wisdom. And with that enthusiasm, I went to my assigned room because I'm going to live in a dormitory for the next 5 years of my life. And when I entered the room, I was shocked when I found out that I'm going to live with 9 more students. 9? Whoa, that's a lot. I mean, 9 different students with different personalities, from different family backgrounds. Who knows, I'm going to sleep next to a psychopath. And it was a total horror. It's like a nightmare, except that it was real. And I felt like I was this. So just when I was recovered from my shock, my cell phone rang and my mom told me that I need to listen to his advices. And I know my mom, when she said advices, she actually meant rule. And she said it the way Moses gave his 10 commandments. And this is how he should say it. Rule number 1, everything in moderation, except on your education. Study, study, study. Rule number 2, know your surroundings and make good, reliable group friends to hang out with. And when I scanned my room, I told my mom, you know what? With 10 people sharing one room, you'll never know what will happen. And she said, finally, rule number 3, don't ever forget that you are in college. Because the life that you already, the freedom that you already have now, this may lead you to distraction. So I said, okay, I got it. And she said, now your dad wants to say something. Dad wants to say something, I mean, seriously? You know, if my mom gives advice like it's a rule, then my dad gives advice like it's from a fool. And he said like this, don't ever forget to cut classes at least once a semester, given that you have your notes with you. And I said, wow, what an advice. And that's how my first day of college began. And you know what? I did enjoy college, except for 2 things. The one is a course, a required course, and the other one is a curse. I'm talking about maths and exams. I never, ever cried in college, except for that one qualifying math and exam. You know what? I'm going to tell you. For those who I considered as math beast, math looks like this. Piece of cake. Very easy. But for me and for the rest of the world, I mean, those who can sympathize, math looks like this. Just numbers. And the exam, of course. That one horrifying exam. You know how amazing it is when our hearing improves during exams? You know, your eyes focus, your mind concentrated, and yet your ears are open for possibilities. No wonder one school did this to their student. All of them with boxes on their heads. And you know that awkward moment when you just keep on laughing. I know I'm screwed up. And you know, this normally happens to that one last minute after in the exam. We cram. So that's life for me. And if I would describe my college life, I would describe it in 3 negative D's. 3 negative D's. Distraction, discouragement, and doubt. And with the 3 negative D's, I conquered it with 3 positive P's. priority, perseverance, and passion. And how did I did it? Simple. When I see distractions left and right like a tug of war, I set my priorities. First thing first. Second, perseverance. When you are discouraged, persevere. And last, when you are discouraged, when you have that doubts in your hearts, passion. It's what brings you the confidence. And I know that every one of us have these, you know, moments when we are like fed up, we feel like we're giving up, we feel like we're going crazy. Well, I have one encouragement for you. Part of being crazy is actually being a little bit crazy. So when we are discouraged, when we are disappointed, when we have these doubts in our lives, believe me, we need to persevere, we need to prioritize, and we need to have that passion. We need to have that passion. And I think surviving college is not just about preserving our sanity, but it's also about fulfilling our dreams one step at a time. Thank you, Toastmaster.
I'd like to ask 1 minute of silence, please.